In this lecture, what we're going to show you is a number of different ways that I can express an enthalpy change that's associated with an equation. To begin with, enthalpy change is symbolized delta subscript R, capital H. We'll find that sometimes in our older questions, we'll see that it's referred to as the heat of reaction. Now, there are three ways that we can indicate an enthalpy change for a given process. We can write out a potential energy diagram. We indicated that in the previous lecture. We can take an enthalpy change and write it inside as a term in an equation. And we can write an enthalpy change as a quantity alongside an equation. So let's look at what I mean. Here we have a reaction that was given in the previous lecture. It's the formation of water. So we have a half O2 plus hydrogen forms H2O. Now, the position of product with respect to reactant indicates to us that this process is exothermic. There is a drop in enthalpy. That would indicate to us that we need a negative sign to accompany the delta H. In this case, it's negative 241.8 kilojoules. Now, if we want to write the same process as a chemical equation, we have to ask ourselves, is that energy a product of the reaction? Is it generated? Or is it a requirement for the reaction to happen? Based on the potential energy diagram, that energy is released. It's a product of the reaction. That means that 241.8 kilojoules then has to be on the product side of an equation. So we'd write the reaction, a half O2 plus H2 produces water, vapor, and 241.8 kilojoules of energy. Now the negative didn't disappear. The negative is represented by the fact that the 241.8 kilojoules is now on the product side of the equation. If I don't want to write that energy value within an equation, but I want to associate it with a given equation, I write the equation out, and then I write the enthalpy change alongside it, which says, as that equation is written, the accompanying enthalpy change is negative 241.8 kilojoules. So now I've extracted it out of the equation that it's associated with, and I've written the delta H value beside. The negative returns in order to indicate whether that energy is or enthalpy change is exothermic or endothermic. So three ways to show the same enthalpy change. In an endothermic process, we'll bring back our reaction from the previous lecture. Here, carbon and water vapor are producing carbon monoxide and hydrogen gas. Now we can see that the products have a higher enthalpy than the reactants, which means the enthalpy increased. Heat must have gone into the system. So the enthalpy change is now positive 131 kilojoules. The positive corresponds to the fact that that's an input of energy. If I want to write that energy value as part of the equation, that positive means that that was something I had to be input. It was a requirement for the reaction to happen. Placed within the equation, I have carbon plus water vapor plus 131 kilojoules yields carbon monoxide and hydrogen gas. To express this enthalpy change alongside an equation, I would write out the equation, carbon plus water vapor gives carbon monoxide and hydrogen gas, and then I would write the enthalpy change that's associated with this equation as it's written is now positive 131 kilojoules. Again, the positive returns to the enthalpy change value to indicate that it is actually a requirement of the process. It's an endothermic change. So again, three ways to show the same change in enthalpy. Just to summarize, there's three ways to show enthalpy change. You can write it within a potential energy diagram. You can write it as a term within an equation. You can write it as a term outside of an equation, but if you do that, you have to bring back the positive and negative.